How's it doing, guys? It's Huck here. I've been thinking of making a video to pick up on a point that Aidan Dowt made in a response to me about the stock market. Has the way it seemed to have what's the word I'm looking for? A distrust in the stock market, right? Because billionaires and millionaires rob from the rich, rob from the poor, and keep to the rich and all that kind of stuff, you know? And that's the kind of impression I got for his comment in his video. I believe that his argument would be that there's corruption in the stock market, which makes it something that he doesn't want to go near, right? That's what I would think. It's a capitalist dream, you know. It's the short sellers, and it's basically people that try to sell you insurance, except in the stock market, you know, they're robbing you and stuff, right? That's kind of what I got, but I'm more than happy to be told I'm wrong. He seems to tend more towards crypto, right? I, on the other hand, kind of see the stock market as, especially now that there is retail investing, retail investors, it's a socialist dream. It is the chance for every working person to own the means of production. Now, yes, there is machinations, there's people who will force things to go down and force things to go up, blah 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 blah, right? Especially when you're talking about financials and trading, you know, shorts and long calls and things like that. There's mechanisms that people with billions have at play that the normal average punter doesn't. But in the same vein, you have things like what happened with Wall Street Bets, where people power can fight back to a point. But see, here's the thing, that to me is all white noise, right? That is like saying bankers are all corrupt, so you don't use an ATM, you know. There's most definitely functionality that you can take from the stock market, right? The same way, like you've got a 401k, or he's got a 401k. Everybody who has a pension uses the stock market, whether they know or not. Their pension pot has been used in the stock market, as far as I'm aware. But there's ways of making sure you don't, I'm not going to say you don't lose, because there's always a chance of losing, but you can definitely hedge your bets. I have a stock that's it's called Ellington Finance, ticker symbol EFC. And if you look at the 5-year chart, it's pretty constant all the way along the line, you know, apart for the big dip during COVID, where it dropped still substantially, but then recovered. I was lucky enough to pick it up on its way back up. But in general, barring hiccups, it stays pretty static along the, let's say, $15 to $18 mark. But it tends to be even more static than that. That, like, if you look at a chart, it's pretty like that. And it provides a dividend yield, right? Because part of its business model is returning money to the people who invest in it. And the dividend is paid monthly, and it is somewhere along the line of 10.18% a year. So you're basically buying a 10-year, a 10% return with very little by way of loss, right? And that's just judging by past performance, right? And of course, I mean, it's like you can buy a house, and something can happen to it. You know, it's no, nothing's foolproof, right? But you're not going to get 10% anywhere else, right? And as opposed to your hot topics items, right? Like maybe Nikola when it was around in a GameStop or whatever. Big risk, big reward. This is minimal risk. Proper investing, right? No trading, not gambling. It's investing. Right? If you don't like that, I think I mentioned it in the last video. I've got a stock. It's a NextEnergy Solar Fund. It's a UK stock based in Jersey, I believe, and it basically collects money and then invests it in solar farms, right? They buy up solar farms and then use that money that they from selling the solar power to provide dividends to the investors. It's every 3 months and it totals something like 7%. And not only have they got a statement of providing a dividend, but of increasing it right over time. It's owning the means of production. It's owning the difference between to for me between that and let's say crypto is that when you buy a share in let's say the solar fund, you're buying a share in a physical thing. You know, you're buying a share in solar farms that exist that sell solar power, which is it's only going to become more useful, not less. Do you know what I mean? Similar to like something like Coca-Cola. If you buy shares in Coca-Cola, you're buying a company with bricks and mortar and mechanisms that produce a product that is then sold to the public, so you know where the value in these things are. And one of my rats has actually just came out of the cage. It's actually Princess, and it's one of the first times she's ever come out of the cage that far. Okay, So, yeah, whereas I get it, like the stock market doesn't steal money, traders do. Do you know what I mean? Investors play the long game, and I think there's value in that, especially for people who want to get some kind of financial return, passive income, while at the same time keeping their but keeping their principal, keeping the money they invested, right? It's not fail safe, it's not foolproof, but this is my motion. This is what I would say about it. Don't expect any response, but yeah, I think sensible due diligence and not betting on hot buttons and fly by nights, and you should be safe. Just an opinion. Anyhow, this is Huck. Peace out.